So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speedboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click on to any of the videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So Andre Ward stops Sergey Kovalev in 8 rounds to retain his unified light heavyweight championship of the world. This was something I wasn't expecting. I was expecting if there was going to be a stoppage or a knockout, it would come by Sergey Kovalev. He'd stop Andre Ward. I thought if Andre Ward was going to win this fight, he was going to win it on points. But Andre Ward said that he was looking to knock Sergey Kovalev out in this fight, and he did that. And people are going to say this is controversial. Like, in my opinion, Sergey Kovalev was hurt. Andre Ward got to Sergey Kovalev. All night long, Andre Ward was trying for them power shots. He was landing the power shots. Don't get me wrong, the fight was very competitive, highly competitive. I think at the time of the stoppage, Andre Ward was up on 2 judges' scorecards, and Sergey Kovalev was up on the other judges' scorecards. So it was very competitive. Sergey Kovalev was doing very well with his jab early on in the fight, and it was really breaking Andre Ward down early on, the jab. But Andre Ward was hitting Sergey Kovalev to the body, landing the power shots. And at the time of the stoppage, what set it up was Andre Ward throwing right hooks to the body, and that really hurt Sergey Kovalev. That really looked like it just took all the life out of him. He backed up to the ropes. Andre Ward landed 3 shots to the belt line of Sergey Kovalev. Sergey Kovalev went down, and referee Tony Weeks stopped the fight. In my opinion, do I think that Tony Weeks should have gave Sergey Kovalev the benefit of the doubt and gave him a count? Yeah, maybe. I think he could have given him that. But Sergey Kovalev looked hurt. He looked like he was in some distress from the body shots that Andre Ward was digging in. Andre Ward hit him to the head as well, into the temple, and I think that buzzed him a little bit as well. So a lot of people are going to cry controversy after this fight. A lot of people are going to be crying, wah, Sergey Kovalev lost, wah, low blows, low blows. Like, I didn't think the shots were low. Like, maybe one out of the 3 shots might have been a little bit low, but I think Sergey Kovalev was pretty much done at the time of the stoppage. Like, I think if the fight would have continued, I think Andre Ward would have eventually landed something and took Sergey Kovalev out, because Sergey Kovalev looked like he was hurt in that fight, and Andre Ward definitely broke him down with the body work. So a very good win by Andre Ward. You can't doubt that Andre Ward is a fantastic fighter after tonight. I know a lot of people don't like Andre Ward. They don't like how he is in the ring. They don't like how he acts outside of the ring. But as a fighter, you've got to give the man the credit. He's gone in there with one of the most dangerous fighters in boxing and managed to pull it off twice. Even if you think the first fight was controversial, even if you think this fight was controversial, in my eyes, Andre Ward did something that no man has done, so he deserves to get some credit now. What does Andre Ward do next? Does he fight Adonis Stevenson, the WBC champion? Sergey Kovalev, after the fight in the post-fight interview, was saying that he wants a third fight with Andre Ward. He feels like the fight shouldn't have been stopped. But in my opinion, Sergey Kovalev looked very angry with himself. He looked angry with himself more than he was angry with the stoppage. He looked upset that he let Andre Ward hurt him, because he was saying that Andre Ward couldn't hurt him in the lead up to the fight. I think he was very disappointed in himself by getting hurt by Andre Ward and allowing himself to get stopped. And he will be, because this is the first time he's lost in this manner. What does Sergey Kovalev do now? Look, there's still big fights out there for Sergey Kovalev. He could fight guys like Artur Beterbiev and Vodzvik, and even Adonis Stevenson. I think that fight could still go down if Andre Ward don't want to fight Adonis Stevenson. Like, who knows what's going to happen? Maybe there will be a third fight. But yeah, it was a good fight, very intriguing. A lot of people are going to go online and create a lot of controversy about the fight. Low blows, some people are going to take camera angles and have a look at the low blow, zooming in on Sergey Kovalev's never regions and saying, yeah, look at that glove and his never regions, and saying it was there, and like, you know what I mean? A lot of people are going to debate this fight again, but I thought that Andre Ward did a lot better than he did in the first fight. I thought he adjusted well to Sergei Kovalev, and I thought that he managed to break Sergei Kovalev down, and he managed to stop him, and he did something that no one said he could do. So yeah, props to Andre Ward. If you think this is controversial, if you don't like the stoppage, that's your opinion, but I think it was a good performance. Don't get me wrong, Sergei Kovalev put in a good shift as well, but I got to give credit to Andre Ward. He's still the unified light heavyweight champion, and I'm giving him his credit. So yeah, it's JM, it's Speed Boxing.